please stand for the salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty and justice for all.
Today is Thursday, April 3rd, 2014. I'm Gennaro.
And I'm Ross Wilds, and you're watching KTV Live, Heroes Villains.
So, Ross, today is International Joke Day.
I know, it's a funny day, actually.
So, let me give you one. What did the duck say when he bought lipstick?
I don't know.
Put it on my bill.
Oh, I get it. That was a good one, nah.
All right, so let's get into today's news.
Let's.
Today's KTV holiday is National Humor Month. This holiday was founded in 1876 by humorist and author Larry Wilde. According to ScienceMadeFun.net, this website also stated that the idea of this holiday is to promote the value of humor in improving health and enriching the quality of life. This is the 38th anniversary of this holiday. Human beings love to laugh, and the average adult laughs 17 times a day.
All 7th grade homeroom teachers need to hand out the group assignment slips to the students.
The Seeing Eye is the oldest existing guide dog school in the world. Recently, Marianne got a chance to catch up with the future Seeing Eye puppy, so let's pass it over to her.
Thanks, guys. So the Seeing Eye was founded in 1929 and has since partnered thousands of individuals to Seeing Eye dogs. And so I got a chance to catch up with a future Seeing Eye dog, so let's see what he had to say. Recently, I got a chance to catch up with a future Seeing Eye dog named Grant. At 8 weeks old, he is beginning his training to eventually lead a blind person anywhere in the world. How are you affiliated with the Seeing Eye?
I am a Seeing Eye puppy in training. When Seeing Eye puppy reached the age of 7 or 8 weeks, they are delivered to the homes of volunteer foster families who care for their charges until they are about 14 months old. Families in New Jersey, Pennsylvania, Delaware, and parts of Maryland and New York give the dogs abundant affection, teach them basic obedience, and expose them to a variety of situations they will later encounter as working dogs.
How long does it take you to become a Seeing Eye dog?
By the time I am 14 to 16 months old, I will venture back to the Seeing Eye and begin formal training. There I will train for 4 months before hopefully being paired with a blind individual. However, only 40% of our dogs will become official Seeing Eye dogs, as many will fail the program for a variety of reasons.
The Seeing Eye breeds Labrador Retrievers, Golden Retrievers, and German Shepherds.
On March 11th, Rio 2 is being released in theaters. According to RioMovies.com, Rio 2 is a 2014 American 3D computer animated musical adventure comedy film produced by Blue Sky Studios. The director of this film is Carlos Saldana. Rio 2 is a sequel of the 2011 film Rio. The blue birds that star in this film are Blue, Jewel, and their three kids. Some people that are starring in this film are Jesse Eisenberg, Anne Hathaway, Bruno Mars, George Lopez, Jamie Foxx, will.i.am, and more. This PG-rated film releases on April 11th.
So, Sydney, before you give me a little preview to the sports I had last night, let me give you a little joke.
Okay.
How you make a tissue dance?
How?
Put a little boogie in it.
Oh, that's a great one, Gennaro, but I think the sports are going to be way better.
All right, so...
So in basketball, the Knicks beat the Nets 110 to 81.
Wow, they're really pushing for that playoff berth.
Yes, definitely. And the Heat beat the Bucks 96 to 77.
Well, the Heat are doing extremely well this season.
And yesterday in baseball, the Yankees lost to the Astros 3-1.
Maybe next time for the Yankees.
I'm a big Yankee
fan.
Yeah,
me too.
And the Red Sox beat the Orioles 6-2.
Red Sox defending World Series champions.
I don't really like the Red Sox.
Yeah, me either.
And speaking of baseball, the Kump boys beat Rahway 15-0, and the girls also beat Rahway 22-0.
Wow, so congratulations to the school teams. So,
yeah, they did a great job.
All right, so see you later.
See you later.
Today's KTV birthday is the one and only Amanda Bynes. According to Famous Birthdays website, she was born in California on April 3rd, 1986. Also, the same website stated that as a kid, she starred in the Nickelodeon shows All That and The Amanda Show. Lastly, she started acting when she was 7 years old in a TV commercial for Bunch of Crunchy Candies. Amanda turned 28 years old earlier this morning.
Yesterday, the Californian Raymond Buxton picked up a giant check for $425 million Tuesday after turning in the winning ticket for the February 19th Powerball drawing. The winner himself stated that he is a die-hard Star Wars fan and will spend most of his winnings on Star Wars gear. So, Ross, it looks like we have one break in the show, so do you want to give me a little joke?
Yeah, I'll give you a good one. Let me see. What happens to a frog's car when it breaks down now?
You got me.
It gets towed away. So let's pass it over to them.
Well, actually, I'm right here. Yeah, I have information on some tennis.
Tennis.
If you want to play recreation tennis, you got to get your forms in by tomorrow.
So everyone should try that. If you're interested in this, fill out a form.
And I have a joke for you guys. How do you get ready for a party in space?
Beats me.
You plan it.
That's a good one. Thanks, Mackenzie.
All right, so for everyone who wants to sign up for tennis, make sure you do that. So let's get back to tennis.
Definitely.
John Michael Green, born on August 24th, 1977, is an American author of young adult fiction. What book made him be number one on the New York Times bestseller list? Is it A, Looking for Alaska? Maybe B, An Abundance of Catherines? Possibly C, The Fault in Our Stars? Or lastly D, Paper Town? According to Wikipedia, John Green, author, This book was number one for 2 weeks in January and February, and the answer is C, The Fault in Our Stars. In this novel, the main character, Hazel Grace, meets Augustus Waters and a cancer support, in which they immediately fall in love. Throughout the novel, they have to cope with through a problem of being together, yet they promise that having cancer will never break them apart. According to Swoop website, their main character, Hazel Grace, is never conscious about explaining and talking about cancer.
Softball and baseball has finally started here at Cump, and teamwork is crucial for any successful team.
What would I do without your smart mouth? Drawing me in and you kicking me out. You got my head.
John C. Maxwell once said, "Teamwork makes the dream work. But a vision becomes a nightmare when the leader has a big dream and a bad team."
How many times do I have to tell you? Even when you're crying, you're beautiful too. The world is beating you down. I'm around through every morning. You're my downfall.
Joe Paterno once said, "When a team outgrows individual performance and learns team confidence, excellence becomes a reality." Mike Krzyzewski once said, "A team is like your hand. When you've got all five fingers to work, they become a fist. That's how I want you to play."
One of the most famous teamwork quotes is, "Individually, we are just a drop of water, but together, we are an ocean."
So, and when I walked in this morning, it was really nice outside, so.
Yes. Well, today it will be sunny with a little bit of clouds, the high of 59.
Finally with the sun.
Tomorrow, it will be rainy with a high of 45. Mm-hmm. Saturday, it will be partly cloudy with a high of 57.
So it's getting up there?
And on Sunday, it will be sunny with a high of 59. So, I mean, it is getting up there, hopefully.
All right, see you later.
There will be an art club meeting Tuesday, April 8th at 2:45 in room 17. Also, there's a book club meeting the 9th and 2:45 in room 13.
All right, Ross. We have one last break in the show over there with Team Bravo.
So let's pass it over to them.
Hey guys, we're here. But also, we might have a little corny joke. Guys, why can't you tell secrets in a cornfield? Because there's too many ears. No? Okay. All right, back to you guys.
That was a great joke, Jeff, but I've been on a roll this entire show.
Yeah, this show, you've been really on this with these jokes today.
I got one more for you. Did you hear about the man with a broken left arm and broken left leg?
I didn't.
Don't worry, he's all right.
Oh, I get it.
So, for even more KTV news, don't forget to subscribe to us on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube. For Ross Wilds and the rest of the KTV news team, I'm Donato. Have a stellar day.